Hi and welcome back to VITA Social News. Thank you that you're back on our social media here. And because I'm not allowed to travel and give some lectures somewhere else, we thought it would be a good idea to do some lectures here on our social media. And I will explain to you our materials and what is a little bit of the background, some hints and some, we will see. I hope you will enjoy it. Today I have the task to talk about our zirconia portfolio. First, I would like to start with a material cluster. So the overview about all the material which you are using in your daily business. It's the oxide ceramic part, it's alumina, and the different zirconias. Alumina, you may all remember, was one of the things used in the 90s of the last century. Procera alumina was at that time the most sold framework material, was veneered afterwards, and then especially in the anterior area it was number one. Then we have the feldspathic blocks, porcelain blocks like VITA materials, the VITA blocks, Trilux and the others. Then we have the glass ceramics, the different ones. We have lithium disilicate and the zirconia reinforced lithium silicates. Then we have different composites. We have low filled and high filled. And of course, there is a PMMA also there. So it is a non-filled material. And on the right side, there's the hybrid ceramics. It's a dual network ceramic. And I tell you, there's only one material existing, which is a hybrid. It's VITA enamic. But I will talk about this material later. Look first on the zirconia. We have in nature three different crystal structures. We have the monoclinic from room temperature to 1170 degrees Celsius. Then above this till 2370 degree, it's getting tetragonal. And then over this, it's cubic till round about 2700 degrees Celsius, and then it's melting. With the putting or adopting of different oxides, it is possible to receive a tetragonal crystal structure at room temperature. There are existing cerium oxide, magnesium oxide, and the known, especially in dental business, known yttria oxide. So if you put yttria oxide, let's say 3 mol% into the zirconia chemical composition, we receive a tetragonal crystal structure at room temperature. The good thing is, or the interesting part of this is, that if there is energy like a crack, like a water, like saliva coming onto that material, we have a transformation, and immediately a transformation from tetragonal into monoclinic. And this is combined with a volume increase of about 4%. And think about, if there is something and there is a crack coming and it's increasing and for volume percent, we directly have a crack slowing or even a stopping of the crack. And that is the good thing. It's called transformation toughening of the material. Now we have four different zirconias. We have the YZT, it's the translucent zirconia. We have the HT material, it's the high translucent zirconia. Then we have a super translucent zirconia, ST, and the extra translucent zirconia, the XT. But what are the differences between them? So it's not just ordering a zirconia disc, it is ordering especially a material. Let us start with this overview. We have the properties, we have the units, and then the four different zirconias on this slide. Let us start with the translucent and the high translucent material. The differences between the two is, you directly see it, is in the amount of alumina content. From the T material to the HT material, we have a lower alumina content. This makes it easy or more easy for the light to go through the material, and we have directly a higher translucency. You see the translucency in the last line of this slide. So it's increasing from 32% to 42% in translucency just by letting a little bit of alumina out of the material. So the light heads is more easy, so the translucency is better. Very simple. Anything else is more or less staying in the same area. The CTE, coefficient of thermal expansion, and also the three-point bending strength is more or less staying at the same level. When we go further to the ST, the supertranslucent material, we have increasing now in the amount of yttria. So we have 4 mole% of yttria. This is increasing also the translucency directly. But we have now less flexural strength or three-point bending strength. The XT has again more yttria content. Now we have 5 mole% yttria, and the translucency is again higher, but the flexural strength is lower. So you see, if we have different compositions, we are also changing slightly the mechanical properties of the material. You see, they are also looking completely different under the SEM, so they are looking different, and also in the grain size, they are different. You see, from T to HT, it's a lower grain size, and the ST and XT, they are looking completely different in this overview. I will not go too deep into this subject. It will take too long to explain this. But coming back to the material properties which are interesting for the dental market, the translucency. We have here a sample of the translucency of the HT material, and as you see on this slide, the translucency is getting higher and better. So with round about 50% translucency, we are close to glass ceramic and in translucency. This slide shows it a little bit more easy to understand. We have here samples lying on a black line, and you can see the line through those samples, and it is more easy to see a sharp line with a higher translucency. And as I mentioned already before, the XT, it is really close to glass ceramic. You can test this with your glass ceramic. Make a sample of 1 millimeter thickness, lay it on a black line, and you see that it is very close to the XT material. I mentioned also that the flexural strength is getting less. So if we put more yttria content into this material, we have less flexural strength. Less flexural strength means that you cannot use the XT material everywhere where you want to use it. Especially in the anterior area where there is no high load from the antagonist, we can use the XT material. The ST material, which has a little bit higher flexural strength, so less yttria content, it's better to use in the posterior area when we do some bridges, two units between the stems. So this would be possible with a ST material. For anything else, let's say 14 unit bridges on implant, I would stay with the old known or well-known T and HT material of the VITA YZ. Another thing is with the yttria content. It is not only changing the flexural strength of the material, we are also changing the fracture toughness. So the resistance against cracks, the resistance against such things. Why it is happening? So if we put more yttria content into the chemical composition of the material, we have now more cubic crystals. The cubic crystals, they do not have such a transforming process. If there is a crack or energy coming onto the zirconia. And if we have less transformation or transforming, toughening, the crack resistance is getting lower. This means also it's not only the flexural strength becoming lower, it's also the fracture resistance or the fracture toughness is becoming lower. So we have now with the XT material, we have an amount of cubic crystals round about 50%, we have just 2.5 K1C or fracture toughness. And the YZT with high fracture toughness, so less yttria content, has a higher, has less cubic crystals, even hard to detect even one cubic crystal. One question always arises in our lectures, in our courses, how to insert this, how to bond this in the mouth to the normal human tooth. We think that the publications of Matthias Kern of the University in Kiel explain it the best. It's quite simple. You sandblast the area slightly with 2 bar and 50 microns edelkorund or aluminium oxide, and then you bond it just normally as you'd bond here on this slide. It's shown with Rela X Unicem and Vita Adiva. Another point is where if you have your own disc, if you have your zirconia disc, the milling strategy is very important. Every material has its own milling strategy. And we are not selling our own machine, we are providing milling strategies for all our cooperation partners. We give them some discs and let them design a milling strategy. Here on this slide you see our disc. It's looking like this when you use the correct milling strategy. How are we doing this? We let them mill some discs with a so-called Merlon or so-called cup. I do a higher magnification of this cup, and you see that the wall thickness of this cup is just 0.2 millimeter thick, and only if they can mill such a cup, they get the VITA approval design. So only if there is a VITA approval stamp or VITA approval milling strategy, you can mill such a cup with our material. And this leads to especially thin veneers, thin edges of the restorations. It's easy to mill then. Another effect is you may also know if you are sintering the zirconia higher, you receive higher grain structures. You see here from 1370 degrees Celsius for 2 hours up to 1600 degrees Celsius for 2 hours. The grain size is getting larger, and then the light has it more easy because there are less boundaries on the zirconia. So the translucency will again becoming better. But another effect is also well known, I think you may have seen this also in some publications. If you are heightening the sintering temperature, we have again a loss of the flexural strength. And this leads again to another point that if you change one thing from the instructions, you are changing also other things of the instructions. And especially in the XT, in the extra translucent material, if you have a lower flexural strength, you cannot even do one bridge because it's too much load, too much energy in the mouth, in the oral system, and it wouldn't be possible to do now even some bridges. So stay with the instructions, don't change them, and you receive the translucency we are providing and also the flexural strength we are saying that you will get. After this, you can do everything with the zirconia. You can color it with VITA YZ liquids. You can sinter it in one sintering furnace like the VITA Zircomart 6000 MS. You can veneer it with Vita VM9 or Vita Lumex AC, individualize it with the Vita Accent Plus, and of course, you get support from us, you get the service from us. If you don't do a comment here on the Facebook, on our social media, you can also write an email to info@vita-zahnfabrik.com and we will try to answer as soon as possible. With the zirconia, you can veneer it completely, fully veneered with the Vita VM9, and you will receive really natural looking restorations. Or, and this is the good thing with the new translucencies of the zirconia, it is more easy to do just small veneerings, so minimal veneering. In this case, it's the cutback and the Vita VM9, and playing with the framework, with the translucency of the framework, it's more easy than with other materials, and you receive in the anterior area or in the aesthetic area, you receive really aesthetic looking restorations. We all know that the market now is going into the monolithic material, so nearly no veneering or even no veneering at all. The point is, in the anterior area, we have the problem that zirconia is not fluorescent. And our natural teeth, they are fluorescent. So we have to do something to bring the zirconia on the same level, on the same stage as our natural teeth. When we look on this slide, the Vita Blocks Mark II, they have a natural behavior or natural fluorescent. When we look at pure zirconia, they have nearly no fluorescence. So we need to apply something, and in our case, it's the Vita Accent Plus Fluoclase LT spray. You apply it, and then you receive the fluorescence as our natural teeth. We have a spray. Why do we have a spray? That you have a homogeneous surface, and you do not have like spots if we would use a paste. So we think that the spray is the better choice to do monolithic material or to apply Accent Plus Fluoclase on monolithic materials. You apply this, then you are firing this, and then you use Accent Plus to individualize some fissures or some necks, and it's up to you. And then you receive such a really nice looking crown, and this is just monolithic. Just use fluoclase and some Fischer Accent Plus. That's it. Yeah, I hope you look again, and I will just in the end remember that we have a new porcelain also. We have the Lumex, Vita Lumex AC, and this is possible to use to veneer, to minimal veneer the zirconia, the different zirconias. It's also possible to use for feldspathic material and also for all the glass ceramic materials which are known on the market. And of course, the Vita Accent Plus and our stain and glaze material. I hope you're coming back and watching again Vita Social News, and I wish you all the best. Stay healthy and goodbye.